items, because if you had 100 blue mage, I need a little bit of a different. You look at it, I still change. So these are, again, UI, very placeholder. There's a lot more work that we want to do in there. Now we offer 10 character slots, but we're still, it's still not final. We're thinking about at least 5 to 8, not fully. So it's here I accept an invitation, we have a party. Let's go. So this was the... Here's the skill interface, so there are two paths here. This is the attributes panel. And this is your inventory. So here I have my items. So I can see here I have empty slots to put my crystals. And also, I did forge that previously in the previous game, so it's level 3 now. So it improves the base stat. So each item has some base stats, which whether it's DPS or armor. So when you forge it, you increase the base stats, and then you have the magical properties on that that will give you the final DPS or armor. So this is the loading screen. So as you can see, there's a dialogue between some of the NPCs that gives you a little bit of an idea what you have to do in the story, in this part of the storyline, in this chapter. Alright, let's start the raid. So this is the scene, the first scene. In this chapter, I made it short a little bit, so there's only one scene. It starts with a cinematic introduction. So here we have Meryl and Adona telling us that Harry Emperor was causing mayhem around Hammerfall. So our goal is to get Harry. Get Harry. Alright. So the controls are fairly typical from action RPGs. I can click and move around, I can avoid projectile. I have my skill bar at the bottom, I can predefine 5 skills. I have my left click and my right click, I can move them around if I want. Okay. I can zoom in a little bit, get a better view of the action. So here we have a bunch of things, so we're going to quickly start to run. Some weapons on the ground, so here I have a small halo, it tells me it's a new item. It's red because it's an assassin blade. So I don't want that crap. Here I have some magical items. I have a green necklace, it's a minor necklace. So let's pick it up and see what's going on. The loot is my own, so no one can steal anything. So when it's dropping there, it's mine until I drop it. If I drop it, then it's fair loot for everybody. So the moment I see it, it's my loot, it's mine, no one can steal it. It's my gold, no one can steal my gold either. So here I have a minor necklace. It's a pretty good one because I have 2 slots for to have some crystal in it. So what I can do is I can double kick on it and then it's equipped. It's a pretty bad support campaign because it's one of my targets. So one of my skills that I really like is this one. Number 5. So number 5 is generating Hall of Lights. So these lights can either heal my character and my friends or can damage people around me that will hit them. As you can see in the color of the skills, so whatever skill that I do. So the first, this is blinding light, so basically it's going to where my cursor is, it's going to generate a blinding light that will do an AoE damage to the monster. This is a regeneration spell, so when my friends are around me, you see they get healed. All the colors of my spells are yellow, they represent the path of Elma. So if I have different path, they will have a different color. So you'll probably see the assassin doing some green skills. skill, that means that these are a part of the leaf. So it's very visual, so you can see what the players are doing. And you can see what are their essentials. Here we have another board of games that we're going to quickly dispatch. I can interact with the environment, sometimes they drop something. We have different types of monster, range, imp, melee imp. We identify them by the color. If they are champions or elites, they will be a little bit bigger. So no champion, no elite so far. This is also random. Here we have a few brigands. I'm going to find one brigand here. He's blind. It's a little bit more difficult with a microphone, but you're blinding light to kill that guy. There are multiple objectives in each raid. So you have the definitive objective of the story, but you also have the same objective up here, or elemental is quicker. So they didn't drop any crystals, unfortunately. So we have some objectives in each of the raids that are the same for each raid. It's 5 objectives plus your normal objectives. First objective, finish the map. Pretty simple. Second objective, find all the chest box. So we have hidden some chest box around in the map to promote navigation. So if you open all the chest box, you get this. You achieve this objective. The other one is kill all the monsters, so you don't have players running through the game without killing the monsters. Not dying, pretty good objective. And finishing the level within 20 minutes. So every raid, we really want them to be a 20 to 25 minute action. So we want to make sure that players have the ability to do it. And each of these achievements or objectives per map are also coded by the level of difficulty. So if I kill all the monsters at the easy difficulty, I will get a bronze medal at the end. And if I kill them at normal difficulty, it will be a silver medal. And if I do it at the hardest difficulty, it will be a gold medal. If I do it at the hardest difficulty, it gets it for all the other previous difficulties. So we're always going to show you in the raider book your progression in types of for each raid, so you can replay it on different difficulties. Where's my phone? So you can see in the minimap, we sometimes show the treasure box. So let's move along. These are the early levels, so we have 12 monsters, different types of monsters per environment, per book. And these monsters can be normal monsters, can be champion, can be elemental, can be boss. And it will affect their shape, size, color, model. They will have extra assets, extra abilities. We also have individual achievements that you can achieve that are here right now. You can have progress and combat achievements. You can get some rewards when you have them. The reward can be gold or experience. You also have a social bar with your friends. When you have a bunch of friends in a raid, you can jump in a raid directly, quickly. So here I'm getting some boxes, and some gold. Boom! So we put some graphical improvement, like moving grass, but we're still working on that. So there's going to be even more graphical improvements to make sure you see that the levels are alive. So part of the story happens right before My Magic Hero 6. In the story, in My Magic Hero 6, there's a blood eclipse coming, which will lead to the invasion of demons. So what? You as a raider, you're called back to the city of Hammerfall. And as a raider, you're here to protect Hammerfall because it's a city that's friendly for the raiders. And as you go along in the storyline, you'll discover that there's something hidden going on, which will reveal to be part of the demon invasion. There's of course more twists in the plot that I'm going to reveal today. So here we have an ice monster. So the effect is totally temporary, it's going to be much more impressive. And these guys have a high chance of dropping crystals. I'm not lucky today. No crystals. So I can see. So now I'm reaching the end of the scene where I'm gonna where there's gonna be an introduction to the boss. So now we're seeing Harry and Flair, who's doing a cool motion of what is his skill, and then the fight starts. So these fights are designed to be much tougher, much more difficult. So that's why it's very important to be to have a group with you when you're killing a boss. If you're there alone, I can tell you it's gonna be a little more difficult.